Welcome back to my channel. My name is Mayowa, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make this one shoulder balloon sleeve crop top. Now, if you've not subscribed to my channel, please hit the subscribe button and also tap the little notifications bell beside your subscribe button so you don't miss any of my upcoming new videos. So for today's tutorial, I'm going to be using this full bodice pattern. So to get this, you can just fold your half pattern, yeah, like your quarter pattern. You can fold it just so you get this full pattern. And this is my front pattern. I'll be showing you everything I want to do on this front pattern. Now, the first thing you need to do is to measure how long you want your crop top to be. So for me, I want my crop top to be exactly 18 inches long. So I'm going to measure 18 inches from here down. So whatever I get, I would mark and draw the line. So I'm going to do that. From here, you extend it as a straight line. Now this is how long a crop top will be. Now for the one shoulder, that is the asymmetric stroke monostrap shoulder, the first thing I'm going to do is to come right here to the shoulder part and measure. I'm going to measure 3 inches from here, because I don't really, or 2.5 inches, because I don't want my shoulder to be too wide. I want the shoulder, so I'm just going to just measure, like, I have 5 inches here. So I'm going to measure 3 inches out. So I'll be left with 2 inches here. Then I would come right here to the armhole level here. I'll come here and then I would measure up 2 cm. Why am I doing that? Just so that it covers a bit of my boobs when I wear it, so just so that my boobs don't spill out from here when I cut this part out. So then you draw a line from this shoulder point all the way here. So I'm going to connect like this. Now this is my asymmetric neckline and my one shoulder sleeve. Now this is all there is to do for this. You do the exact same thing for the back piece, but the only thing that you would exempt from that, you add to the back piece, is to add your zip allowance. Except you want your zipper to be at the side, then you don't need to add your zip allowance. But if you want your zipper, for me, I want my zipper to be at the back of my crop top. So I'm going to, I would slash this part open, and then I would get my zip allowance. But your back pattern already has your zip allowance, right? Your basic back pattern should already have your zip allowance. So all you have to do is just draw your asymmetric line, and then you cut it open, just like we do as two separate back pieces, just like we do when we are cutting our back pattern. Now I'm going to do a bit of alteration at the darts here, because I want my dart piece to, I want it, my boobs to be like a bit firmer on my I want my bust to be a bit firmer, so I'm going to measure down. I'll measure 10 cm down like this. Then from this dart leg here, I'll measure out 1 cm here, and from this dart leg also here, I'll measure out 1 cm. I hope you can see what I'm doing. So I'll measure out 1 cm from here out, 1 cm from here out, just so that the bust becomes like really firm. I want to contour my bust, which is just another way of contouring my bust, so it becomes like really firm and it hugs and clings closely to my body. So I'll be doing that now. Then I'll connect to my bust point here. Then you draw your new dart legs, like you connect it here. Now since my blouse is going to, like, because I added a new length to my blouse, I'm just going to extend the dart leg all the way to the hem here. Then you do the same also for the other side. Now that's all you have to do to this pattern. All you need to do next is to add in your allowances, quarter inch here, half inch here, 1 inch at the side, and at the hem here, I'm just going to add like 1.5 inches. And that's all you have to do to your front pattern. So for the back, remember, you're not going to be extending this dart that I used, that I did on the front dart. You'll be using your normal back dart for your back pattern, and then you do the same length of shoulder, the same neckline for the back. But remember to like add in your zip allowance at the middle, and that's that about that. So I'm going to be cutting this out of my fashion fabric right now. Now these are my cut out pieces. So this is a velvet fabric that I have. I've used the velvet fabric for my blouse. So when you're cutting, please remember to, because this velvet fabric stretches like in one direction. So you find out the part where the stretch is like optimal. So my stretch is here, and then there's no stretch here. You can see that. So I made sure that I placed my pattern in such a way that the part with the most stretches, like comes round my body like this, rather than it being like this. This is not giving off any stretch. So, and then remember to like notch your darts and transfer all your dart points on your fabric using a tailor's chalk or whatever. Now these are my two back pieces. This is it cut open, like my zip allowance is here. So once I'm sewing and I fold up my zip allowance, I'll put my zip in the middle here. So, and then remember also to notch your dart and transfer all your dart points to your design fabric. Now remember, before you cut your blouse, remember to always like hold a bit of the neckline here, just so that it doesn't gap. So you hold a bit of your neckline, you hold a bit here, and you hold a bit here, and draw a new neckline, so that your blouse, your neckline won't be gaping when you are done sewing. And that's that for that. Now for the sleeve. Now before I talk about the sleeve, you can either use a lining to turn the neckline of this, or you can cut a facing. I won't be using my velvet fabric as for the facing, because I don't want it, because it will be bulky. The velvet fabric is already bulky on its own. If I now use like a velvet fabric again for the facing, it's going to make this place a bit too thick, and it's going to make the neckline a bit too thick, and it will not be like very flattering. So you can either use a bias tape, or you can use another fabric. Maybe you can use like a lighter fabric to this as a lining or as a facing. But I'll be using a facing for me. I won't be using a lining, so I'll be using a facing, but I'll cut the facing in another separate fabric. And that's that for that. Now for the sleeve, there are two ways of achieving this umbrella sleeve. But the first one is to get your sleeve block pattern. That is your basic sleeve block pattern. You would slash it open. You draw your slash lines in and then you slash it open and spread out. Just so you can have like a huge volume in the middle that you will be gathering back with elastic. The way I'm using today to cut my umbrella sleeve is to do a circle. So I'm going to cut it as a circle pattern. Now to do that, I'm going to measure around the armhole like this. So I have 9 inches here. That is 9 times 2, because this is like the armhole of the back, and then the armhole of the front also, you measure that and that will give me 18 inches. So that is the armhole of both the front and back, that is 18 inches. Then you add 2 inches allowance to it, so that gives me 20 inches. Now to get this circle, it's not a full circle pattern, I'm going to be doing like a half circle pattern. So to get this, I'm going to get that 20 inches, I'll multiply it by 2.5. You know, I already work with centimeters. So you multiply your 20 inches by 2.5, you subtract 5 from it, and I'm going to divide by 3 instead this time around. So I'll divide by 3, that is 20 times 2.5. Whatever you get, you subtract 5 from it, and then you divide by 3. So whatever I get, I'm going to measure it like this. So I got 15 cm. All you have to do is to, and I've already measured that. Now this is how I did it, 15 cm, like this, and then like this. So you measure 15 like this, and that is what I have here. Now from, you measure how long you want your sleeve to be. Now me, I want my sleeve to be like 25 inches, 25 to 26. So I'm going to measure that length like this all the way down, then I'll come right here and measure 26 inches again, 26 inches, like this, and you get the drift. So I would be doing that now, just so you can see. Don't forget to add half inch allowance here, your half inch. So after measuring all you have here, then you add your half inch here, half inch. Now, then you cut it out. So I'm going to cut it all out now. And this is my completed circle sleeve pattern. Now, we move right ahead to sewing this. Now, the first step in sewing this is to sew the darts. You sew the darts and then you do the same also for the back. Then you come right here and place your lining or your facing right sides together, and then you sew the neckline, and then you top stitch. Then after that, you do the same also for the back. Then this next step after that is to place both your front and back pieces together at the shoulders, and then you sew the shoulders together. Then the next bit after that is to place your sleeve at the armhole, and then you join your side seams together and fix your zip at the back, and that's the end of sewing this. For the hem, you can just close it by 1 inch, so you can fold it by 1 inch, just so everything is neat and all of that. And that's basically all there is to it. Now these are the darts all ironed down and sewn, the hem also pressed down. This is my neckline. I used a different type of fabric, not this, as I explained earlier, for my neckline. And this is the back and all of that. Now the next thing is for you to come right here and place your sleeve here. So place our sleeve here, but before you do that, you pick up your sleeve piece, this one here, and then you come to the hem here. You can measure You can measure 6 inches up or however you want it. Then you cut another strip of fabric with your velvet or whatever design fabric you're using. So you cut another strip of fabric and then you sew it down. You measure 6 inches or 5 inches from here up, and then you sew this extra piece of fabric that you just cut. Make sure you cut this extra piece of fabric on bias, not as a straight line. You cut it on bias, then you sew it down like this, and then it's going to look this way on the other side. So this enclosing, this closing here, this casing here is where we'll be putting in our elastic to gather up this side for the sleeve. I hope you understand what I'm talking about. So the elastic is going to gather it up. So let me just re-summarize what I just said. So you place your the extra piece of fabric, you place it like this, and then you sew to make sure that what you have, like the casing for the elastic, is not more than 3/4 inches. So this, you can then decide to trim this extra, or you can leave it like that, anyhow you want it. And that's basically it. Then you sew this part to the armhole of your bodice, and that's what I'm going to be doing now. So now, to place the elastic inside this part, all you have to do is to measure around this part of your arm or wherever you want the ruching to be. So, but for me, I'm going to measure here. That is 9 inches. So I'll measure my elastic. Instead of measuring 9 inches, I'll measure 8 inches, just so it is firmer. Then, using a pin like this, we'll use this to pass the elastic through the enclosing, through the casing rather. I'm going to cut this extra bit of fabric off. Once this is all the way in, I'll tack this down just so that this doesn't enter into the closing. So now I'm going to tack this bit down. Now this is what this is going to look like when you are done passing the elastic through. This is it. Now the next thing is for you to attach this part to the armhole of your bodice, and then join the side seams and fix your zipper at the back. And that's the end of making this one shoulder umbrella sleeve crop top. So I'm just going to put all of this together and show you what the final look is going to look like. And that's it, guys. Please hit the subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up sign, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.